Hey everyone, it's Ange here. Welcome back to my channel. And if this is the first time you're here, welcome. I'm so happy to have you. So I am obsessed with planning my life out because I have so much going on. So I figured I would give you guys a look into my passion planner and kind of how I set up my weeks. So stick around and let's dive in. So 2018 was the first year I finally committed to using one planner for the entire year. We are almost at the end of December and I have made it through. I'm so proud of myself. And unfortunately, Passion Planner has decided to only make a smaller size. So I am moving on to Law of Attraction for 2019. But I figured I'd pop on and show you guys kind of what this week looked like at the end of the week with all the scribbles, and then kind of how I set up a fresh week. So every week I kind of like to use different colors, but stick with one color for different activities. I always start with kind of the huge blocks of time that are predetermined. So these are my work shifts at my job. The next thing I kind of block off is what my spouse is working. So at the top, I always have his schedule. So he's on days next week, which means I need to get our child ready and off to school. So I've blocked off with some nice washi tape here from Monday to Friday, kind of the hours that I'm going to dedicate to, you know, spending time with her and getting her ready for school. So that's taken care of. The other thing that I kind of know I have to plug in right away are the clients that I support who have autism. So if I have sessions booked for that week, I will pop those in one color. Another huge commitment that takes up a lot of time that's easy to plug right into your schedule is children's activities. So my daughter dances very regularly. So she's got dance here and here, usually on Saturdays as well, but since Christmas is coming up, we are taking a break. So you've got all your basics in. The next thing I personally plug in for myself is the yellow. You will see it across the bottom of every day, as well as across the top of every day. I take 1 hour in the morning and half an hour in the evening for self-reflection and self-care. So the morning routine looks a little different than the evening routine, but both involve journaling, that kind of thing. The morning is based off of The Miracle Morning, so I definitely suggest you check out that book if you have no idea what to do with your mornings. So I've got that important time planned out. Next thing I plug in is my team training with my team, because that happens every single Wednesday at the same time, so I kind of know that's happening as well. I had some social plans this week with it nearing the holiday, so I have a couple of dinner plans with some different groups of people, so I have those with nice stickers to kind of remind me. Since I tend to have gone with purple for my business task for my team, so this is apart from my job, this is my business that I run on my own, that is a guarantee of what's happening in that hour. But then I've also gone ahead and chunked off some other bits of time that are dedicated specifically to my business as well. The ones that are colored in or written in have a specific plan. These other three blocks of time are to be determined based on the day's needs and the week's needs, that kind of thing. But at least I know that I've set aside some time to work on my business. Other things that I like to plug in are my self-care. So I put the times that I want to go to the gym, which is at least 3 times per week. And when possible, I multitask. So one of my client sessions, we will be going to the gym together. So I make sure to pop that in. Over here, I'm going to determine the week's focus on Sunday. Keep track of all the positive things that happen throughout the week. As you can see, I do that as the week fills out. On the bottom here, I like to split the personal to-do in half. On one side of the page, I list out all my chores that I want to get accomplished during the week with check boxes, so I can just tick those off whenever I can fit them in. And then over here, I've got my 3 check marks for going to the gym, other things and errands I know I need to do, like groceries, going to get a photo taken with Santa Claus this week, finishing Christmas shopping, that kind of thing. On this side, you've got your work to-do list. So I already know that I need to be working on some January activities. I also have a spot here where I've just added a sticker and I've labeled it personal development. So just keeping track of the things that I'm doing for my personal development to hold me accountable. So far, I have a one-on-one coaching session booked with someone, but then I'm also gonna keep track of any podcasts I listen to or books that I read. Over on this side of the page, I have kind of a couple of habit trackers for the week. So drinking my green smoothie, doing my daily meditation, my gratitude log, and then my nightly care routine. So just checking off one for each day of the week for all of those. And it does leave me more blank space for notes or whatever might come up. So on Sunday, probably when I get back from groceries, I will have another chunk of time blocked out to finalize planning my week. And then every morning when I get up, I determine what the day's focus is going to be during my power hour. And I kind of determine the top three things I want to get done for the day. Oftentimes I will list out my to-dos or my top threes in these big chunks when I'm at work, just because I find that to be an effective use of space. And then I, as you can see, by the end of the week, everything looks scribbled on and messy, but I have been loving the Passion Planner. Again, if you can work with a smaller version of this, then I highly recommend it. If you want to check out the Law of Attraction Planner, I will link that video down below. It seems very, very similar, possibly even better, so I can't wait to dive into that one. If you like videos about productivity and organization, then please feel free to subscribe and give this video a thumbs up. We'd totally appreciate it. We'll see you all next time.